Hello everyone, welcome to the Guru Deeksha. I'm Sai Kiran. Here I stand, appears with a nice and easy playlist of statistics. Let's begin our one more part of statistics. Data collection. Statistical investigation is always based on systematic collection of data, the reliability of conclusion drawn from the sample of it. We have some measures to collect the data. Collection of data depends on objective, scope, and nature of problem. And usually data can be collected generally by primary data and secondary data. If you know there is a census, counting census for every 10 years in India, they do like this primary data by sending the volunteer to the houses, and they get collect data of the families and who is the head of the family, what they are doing, I mean what occupation they are doing, what income are they collecting, and what expenditure they are spending. They do collect these data by the primary source of data. Let's move to primary data and secondary data. Primary data, I also told you that it is a census count data which is collected for first time or original in nature. A volunteer goes to the house and collect the data in a manner of questionnaire. They have some questionnaire list, like first with the family head name. Head name is, can be divided into surname, first name and last name, age, gender, occupation and income. Later go to the family details like mother, children and what they are doing and what they are studying, whatever may be, and ask the locality number, locality location, door number, collect their mobile numbers or email IDs. Based on the questionnaire what they have prepared, the source from which data are collected is called a primary source. Those data is collected by field workers, investigators and enumerators. Methods to collect primary data are direct personal interview. Volunteer comes to us and asks the personal data. Indirect personal interview. Government can send volunteers to us to collect data, and mailed questionnaires if they are really eligible to do this, but government is not taking that mailed questionnaires, because if they get response or not, or due to any technical issues, the mailed questionnaires are very less, and information from local agencies and correspondents. If you have a big locality, they are divided into the local agencies, and the local agent will come and ask us details, like insurance agents will ask us, would like to ask us the, if they interested, if the people are interested to take an insurance premium. Likewise also government can collect the data too. Going to the secondary data, data which is collected with some earlier agency, which can be data can be stored very perfectly previous of this by the agency, we doesn't know, but it is used and analyzed by any other for its own use. We have some sources like published sources and unpublished sources, like government publication, published sources like government publication, international publications, semi-official publications and private publications too. Coming to the published sources, there are number of national and international agencies which collect statistical data relating to business, trade, labor, prices, consumption, production, agriculture, industry, health, income, socioeconomic characters, and publish their findings in statistical reports on regular basis, monthly or quarterly, annually, etc. Take a look about the government publications. The government organization which can collect data and publish statistical data on various fields to the सेंट्रल स्टैटिस्टिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, नेशनल सैंपल सर्वे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ऑफिस ऑफ द रजिस्टर जनरल एंड सेंसस कमिश्नर, डायरेक्टर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिक्स, लेबर ब्यूरो, मिनिस्टर ऑफ लेबरी, लाइक दिस इंडिया कैन कलेक्ट डाटा फ्रॉम द सेकेंडरी डाटा, लाइक दे गेटिंग सेकेंडरी डाटा. इंटरनेशनल पब्लिकेशंस, पब्लिकेशंस लाइक various foreign governments and international agencies like UNO, United Nations Organization, World Bank, International Monetary Fund. Nowadays we can look about a COVID-19 too. COVID-19 reports generated by the hospitals they are sending to the WHO, and UNO collect these data and publishing which country has the highest recovery, highest death cases, highest recovery rate, and showing us in a list manner. Like they also spreading news like with this list form only. When coming to the private publications, annual reports of private banks, information published in papers and books in magazines too. Yes, of course we can collect. We are also collecting data. When you look about a data science, we go to we are going to the browser and searching for data science from Wikipedia and some YouTube like Gurudev Shah, Resistive Data Science or datakind.org. We are gathering what is data science, what they can do, what data scientists can do, what is the salary they are, and we can do. We can also collect from the magazines, articles, or medium articles. Medium articles now have a very nice platform for the data science. Go with Medium and check there. You have very interesting data science articles, and that's our suggestion too. We have also some precautions for using secondary data. The organization must check whether the data is reliable and suitable for the statistical survey. The investigation team should check whether the data is sufficient for present investigation or not. These are the main two precautions for using a secondary data by the government or international publications. So far we completed about the primary data and secondary data. Now let's move to the qualitative and quantitative. These are the two main topics for the entire statistics, what you have to do. Qualitative refers to a quality or categorical character or something, whereas quantitative refers to a quantity or numerical character or something. And nominal and ordinal or level of measurements, we can discuss later the level of measurements, interval and ratio or level of measurements. In case of qualitative, the examples are rating of a game in Play Store like good, bad, or ultimate, or maybe average or excellent, not bad, like that. When coming to the quantitative, temperature in Celsius or Fahrenheit degrees. Coming to the level of measurement, measurement was developed by Stanley Smith Stevens. With four levels of classification, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. What is level of measurement? Level of measurement is a classification that describes the nature of information. In four of these level of measurements, we use mostly nominal. Nominal, which represents the categories, colors, labels, and liked foods, along with yes or no responses. The nominal level is the lowest measurement level used from a statistical point of view. The three measures are used mostly for nominal, ordinal, interval, or ratio, are the descriptive, diagnostic, and predictively. Descriptive is the richest basic form of level of measurements. When coming to the age of level of measurement, Here, is must be there for level of measurement. Of course, the is must be calculated in the form of ratio, because it has an absolute zero value and the difference between the values is very meaningful. The important tip for the video is statistical forecasting. Statistical forecasting implies the use of statistics based on historical data to project what could happen out in the future. It can be based and implies on any quantitative data, stock market results, sales, GDP, and etc. In coming to the data science, the statistical forecasting always have 50% error and 50% accuracy. By correct predictions, we can use only through graph representative of mean, median, and mode data. At the end of these classes, we can discuss about the statistical forecasting. Different types of graphs used to show results of statistical conclusion data results. One is bar chart, second is pie chart, third is histogram, fourth is scalar part, fifth is Pareto chart, and sixth is the frequency. This frequency we can use mostly at our 10th class or 10th grade, mostly. About this, coming to the bar chart, there is a series 1, series 2, and series 3 with 4 different types of categories. And pie chart also, we can divide pie chart into different types of quarters, maybe first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, and fourth quarter. This represents the sales. I take this pie chart as a sales. And histogram, scatter plot, only pointing out the points here. And Pareto chart is the two charts that include with a line chart, a bar chart, or histogram chart. And thank you. Meet you on next video. If you want to stay here and learn newly, please do subscribe our Guru Diksha channel and get our updates frequently. Have any doubts, please do mention at our comment section. Do like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Bye.